I'm from Arkansas. And you're probably wondering, where is Arkansas? Don't worry, you've probably not been here. It's not exactly a vacation destination. So I certainly never thought that I would meet my favorite actor here. But my hometown is also Walmart's hometown, so it does have some perks. My brother is a wonderful artist, and for my 30th birthday a few years ago, I asked him to draw me a picture of Robert De Niro. It was more from the Casino era, and I was hoping for the Taxi Driver era, but it's okay, it was really great. Then one day I heard on the radio that Walmart was partnering with the Bentonville Film Festival, and that Robert De Niro was coming to Arkansas. I almost had a heart attack. Why in the world would Robert De Niro be coming to Arkansas? So I bought an all-access pass. I wasn't quite sure what day he'd be coming or where he'd be, but I wanted to make sure I would see him, even though I couldn't afford the all-access pass. So the day before the event, I went to the room I found out he'd be in, just to practice, to get the lay of the land, get the best seat, make sure I'd be able to meet him if possible. Well, I was overprepared, because I was the only one in line for hours on the day of the actual event. But my preparation paid off because I got in first and I got in the front row. And then here in this beautiful Crystal Bridges Museum, I'm sitting in the front row, and on the glass walls, I see Robert De Niro and his entourage coming. And then he comes into the room, and there he is. Robert De Niro, my favorite actor, right in front of me. And he looks really grumpy. And so I'm thinking, I may not be able to meet him. But that's okay, I got a plan B. He was there to talk about his father's artwork. HBO had done a documentary about his father who had never quite got the recognition and success that he wanted as an artist. And Robert De Niro really tried to help his father pursue that dream. And that's what the documentary was about. And afterward, they opened it up to questions. And I figured since he looked so grumpy, I wasn't going to be able to meet him, but I could at least ask a question and say we'd had a conversation. And as the questions kept coming and kept going, they said, "Mr. De Niro, you're my favorite actor. Mr. De Niro, I want to be just like you." And he never said thank you. In fact, hearing compliments looked like it irritated him to death. And so I saw that they were coming around with the last questions, and they didn't give me the microphone. So with death eyes, I looked at the guy with the microphone, and I said with my eyes, "You better give me that microphone." And I got the microphone. And I said, "Mr. De Niro, my brother, he's a wonderful artist. And I think he struggles with modesty, or he's embarrassed, and he doesn't want to put himself out there. What can I do to help my brother, encourage him to put his artwork out there, and help my family member who I love?" And Robert De Niro said, "He just needs to do it." So of course, right after that, I called my brother and I said, "Jeremy, Robert De Niro said you just need to do it." But after that, the session was over and he was getting up to leave. And I knew this was my opportunity. So for whatever reason, I grabbed the artwork that my brother had brought and I just hopped up onto the podium and I said, "Mr. De Niro, this is the picture that my brother drew of you. Do you like it?" And Mr. De Niro looked at it and he said, yeah, I do. And I said, "Will you autograph it?" And he said, "Yeah." And he reaches in his breast pocket and I'm like, "I've got a pen!" No cap already, ready to go. And he autographed it. And then after that, I wasn't quite sure what to do, so I just bowed and I walked away. That's it.
Okay.